AWS Serverless Application Model, or AWS SAM, is an open source framework for building serverless applications. A typical serverless application consists of one or more AWS Lambda functions triggered by events, such as object uploads to Amazon S3, Amazon SNS notifications, or maybe API calls. A serverless application is defined in a CloudFormation template and deployed as a CloudFormation stack. An AWS SAM template is an extension of AWS CloudFormation. It also includes AWS SAM CLI that provides a Lambda-like execution environment that lets you locally build, test, and debug applications defined by SAM templates. In this video, we're going to create three Lambda functions from scratch. The first one will consist of the Node.js Lambda functions packaged as a zip archive and triggered by AWS API Gateway. The second Node.js Lambda function is triggered by uploaded file in S3 byte. The third one will be a Python function packaged as a Docker image and subscribed to the Amazon Simple Notification Service SNS. You can find source code in my GitHub repository along with all the commands that I used in this video. The link will be in description. First of all, we need to install AWS SAM CLI. Based on your development host, choose the installation instructions. I'm on Mac and I always prefer to use Homebrew Package Manager to install additional software that I need. Let's go to the terminal and run brew tab aws tab. Homebrew tabs are third-party external repositories that contain formulas to install packages on your OS. Then simply run brew install AWS SAM CLI. It will use the AWS SAM CLI GitHub repo to download the tarball. To verify installation, let's check the version of AWS SAM CLI. Most likely, you will get the higher version, which is fine. Now we need AWS IAM user to continue with our tutorial. To simplify, I will create an admin user. However, you should always try to follow the least privileged security principle if possible. Let's click add user and give it a name admin. This user will only need to have programmatic access. That means you won't be able to use it to log into AWS console. Let's place it in the admin AWS IAM group and click next. We will download the credentials file and use it to configure AWS CLI. Now let's use the cat command to print out the credentials and use them with the AWS configure command. I assume that you already have basic AWS CLI installed. To double check if you configure it correctly, you can use the AWS STS get caller identity to verify the user. Sometimes I forgot to delete AWS environment variables, which take precedence over AWS profiles. AWS SAM CLI comes with a wizard that guides you through creating an example. You can run some init and answer a couple of questions to get a working Lambda function. We will go through this, but won't use it in this tutorial. First, you can select either you want to use prepared by AWS templates or use your own. The next question is how you want to package your function. Either zip archive or a Docker image. For years you can only use zip, and recently AWS introduced a way to package your functions as images, which is my preferred method. In this tutorial we will do both, zip and image. Then you need to select a runtime such as Node.js, Python or any other. Let's give it a package name SAM. The last question is the name of the template. We're going to select the first one, Hello World example. Let's open the generated project. We have a CloudFormation template with additional properties that come from SAM. We have a serverless Lambda function. And the events.json file with an example of the request forwarded to the Lambda from the API gateway. Now let's delete it and start from scratch. Let's create a folder with the same name SAM. This folder will contain all our Lambda functions. The first function will be triggered by the external API POST request. Let's create an API folder for it. Since it's a Node.js function, we need to change the directory to that folder and run npm init to initialize the Node project. This will generate a package.json file. Let's use default values for all the questions except the entry point. Give it a function.js name. Let's confirm and let's take a look at the generated file. Now let's create the Lambda function itself. It will take the event object that we already saw and a node context with the following properties. Let's declare the response variable that we return to the client. In our case, it will be a curl command and a body of the function that will parse the event and create a response object. We're going to put it in try-catch block.
To define the resources that need to be created in AWS, we will use the CloudFormation template with some additional properties that AWS Serverless Application Model SAM provides. First is the template formation version. It identifies the capabilities of the template, and the last version is 2010.09.09. Then we will add the transform key, an optional section that specifies macros that AWS CloudFormation uses to process your template. AWS Serverless 2016.10.31 is required for AWS SAM template files. It extends the CloudFormation template with additional properties that we will use for our serverless application. Then the self-explanatory description key. Global variables can be used among functions. For example, if all your functions only need 128 MB of memory, you can declare one here. The same with the runtime. Now the Lambda itself. API function is an abstract name that can be used to reference this function within the template. Then the type. You have six different types: function, API, HTTP API, application, simple table, and a layer version. We will start with AWS Serverless function and provide properties. Node.js 14 is a runtime function. Lambda handler is a Node.js function that we declared previously. Code URI is a source folder for the function, then a 3-second timeout. The event section describes the events that can trigger the function. You have multiple options here. We're going to use API for our first function. Also, we need to provide some properties to define the AWS API gateway. Let's create a path hello and specify the post method. At this point, you can continue and AWS SAM will generate a default AWS gateway spec for you. However, if you need more flexibility, it is better to declare the API resource separately and use the ref CloudFormation function to reference that object. Now let's create a different type of object, AWS Serverless API. It creates a collection of Amazon API Gateway resources and methods that can be invoked through HTTPS endpoints. An AWS Serverless API resource should be used to define and document the API using OpenAPI, which provides more flexibility to configure the underlying Amazon API Gateway resources. You can either define a definition body or a definition URI that points to the complete OpenAPI spec, or just provide few variables such as stage name, OpenAPI version, to override some default properties. Here is a complete list of parameters that you can use. We can also declare some output variables that can be printed out when all the resources are created. Those variables can be generated automatically, such as an API function IRN, or static variables, for example tutorials. You will see them when we run SAM deploy. Now we have a complete CloudFormation template to create our first function and API gateway. Let's go to the terminal and run the SAM build command, which will create artifacts and SAM template. To test an AWS Lambda function, which is triggered by the API gateway locally, we need to simulate an event that passed from API to the Lambda. Let's create an event.json file and define a body name equal to Anton. To run the local invoke function, you need to have a Docker installed on your host. Let's run it and we get the correct response from the function. To deploy an AWS SAM for the first time, you need to run SAM deploy with a guided flag. It will generate a config for you to avoid answering the same questions all the time. Let's give it a name SAM and answer other questions. First of all, it will create an S3 bucket and upload the artifacts and templates generated by the SAM build command. Let's say yes to deploy this change set. Those are output variables, computed AWS Lambda IRN and static tutorials. Now let's go to AWS console and check the S3 bucket that was created. Now let's go to Lambdas. Right now we have only one function, which is integrated with API gateway. To invoke this function, let's copy the URL and use curl and provide a payload. You don't need to specify a type of request if you provide a payload. Curl will automatically assume that you want a POST request. Let's run it and we get a hello Anton from our Lambda function. To test it from AWS console, let's create a new event test name and provide a payload. Save changes and click test. Under the details, we have a response. You can also see the duration and memory usage of that function. It's time to create our next Node.js AWS Lambda function that will be triggered by the uploaded object to the S3 bucket. Let's go to the S3 folder and initialize the Node.js project. Same function.js for the entry point. Now let's define the function. First, we need AWS CDK and initialize the S3 object. In the body of the function, let's get a bucket name from the event and the key, which is the name of the file that we will upload to the bucket. In the try catch block, let's get a content type of the object and print it out to the console. We will be able to see the output in the CloudWatch log. Since we're using additional Node.js modules, we need to install them using the npm package manager. It will also add this AWS CDK to the package.json as a dependency. We can use the same CloudFormation template to add the second function. The type will be in the AWS Serverless function. Same Node.js runtime and handler. Code URI's location is different and increase the timeout to 60 seconds. Now the event. Let's give it an arbitrary name, print event of type S3. A complete list of supported properties can be found here. The link will be in description. Under the bucket properties, we will specify a bucket name to watch. Example bucket is a reference to the S3 bucket that we will create next. Unfortunately, you cannot use the existing buckets using the SAM template. You can only create a new bucket. There are few workarounds, I also attach some links. The last event's key will specify what type of S3 event to subscribe to trigger a function. In our case, when an object is created. Finally, let's create a S3 bucket and give it a unique name. Optionally, we can add another output name with the RN of the function. RN stands for Amazon resource name. Let's go to the root SAM folder and build a project. Since we already have an AWS SAM config file, we don't need to run SAM deploy guided, just deploy. It's pretty much the same thing. It will upload functions and create necessary AWS resources. First, let's check if our additional S3 bucket was created. Here is our test Anton Putra bucket. Let's go to the lambdas and we have two functions now. Click on S3 function. Later on we're gonna use the view logs button. Now go back to the S3 bucket and upload the readme file. If you go to the CloudWatch logs right now, we should see that the function was invoked. Here's the console log output from the function. Content type for key, readme, md is binary octet stream. For the third function, we will use the Python programming language and package it as a Docker image. To trigger this function, we will use Amazon Simple Notification Service. It's very common to create a function to react to some internal AWS events. It may be security events or some alerts. There are a lot of use cases with AWS SNS. Let's create an SNS folder and function.py file. This function will listen for new messages in our AWS SNS topic and print out the content. Just in case if you're going to use additional packages, let's create requirements.txt file but leave it blank for reference. To package this function as a Docker image, we need to create a Docker file. Let's use public lambda image with Python, then copy the function and requirements files to the image. Install dependencies if you have any and finally specify the command to start the Docker container. We need to add this function to our AWS SAM template. type is AWS Serverless function. Package type at this point will be image and not zip. Location of the function and the event section to trigger the function. Here we need to specify the IRN of the SNS topic. We're going to create this next from the AWS console. To package function as a Docker image, we need an additional metadata section to specify the name of the Docker file, context, and a tag. We also can add output variable if you want. From the AWS console, let's search for SNS and create a topic for our test. From the terminal, run SAM build. At this time, it will build a Docker image as well for our Python function. Since we will need to specify the Docker ECR repository, let's run SAM deploy with the guided option. We need to create a private ECR repository. Let's go to Elastic Container Registry and create an SNS repository. Let's copy the URI and use it for the image repository. Time to test the function. You can see that the package type now is image. Let's click on SNS function. Go to the SNS topic and publish the hello message. Go back to the function and use the View Logs button. You see the log entry indicating that our function was invoked and it printed out SNS message hello. In this lesson we created three functions. First one was triggered by an API call, the second was triggered by an object created in S3 bucket, and the last one was from SNS topic. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.